used to be Deku's, but the point, because of the mispronunciation of his tag, he just shortened it, saved time for everyone at that point.
Neato.
And yep. I love the choice to go to Luigi's Mansion for the hand warmer.
Yeah, because you can hit that pillar as long as you want, as long as the top one doesn't break.
Exactly.
There's just hit lag for you to practice on. It's really good for developing spacey pressure, snake up B and up air, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Things where you want to hit very quick, tight successions of moves, but you want hit lag with which to practice. Because it changes up the timing slightly. So now we'll see the pillars break momentarily. Yeah,
yeah. And we've seen that Vandals. Especially with... if you want to practice like Shine Pressure as Fox or Falco, perfect stage for it. If you
That's it. That's what you're talking about.
That's the Thought Walk. And
Pancake's laughing. I don't know if you've seen that before.
Yeah, and it's just immediately. It's
just jumping, right?
A bunch of successive float cancels. Exactly. I mean, arguably float cancel, you have to go for the aerial first. But people just called it Thought Walk because Peach is probably one of the only characters that can opt for it besides Yoshi.
Right.
So.
I messed around a little bit with that with Yoshi, too.
And he got that tech because Pug from UNT, who's probably one of my favorite Yoshis to watch, great development with that tech as a whole, opting for things like up tilt out of shield, down smash out of shield.
That's
with Yoshi.
Sick.
And then Jay was like, I want to do that because I know Peach can.
Hmm.
So just immediately moving on the legacy, if you will. Shoutouts to Pug for... bringing great tech on the line, especially for players like we're seeing here at this Arcadian.
Pancakes with first blood.
And with that hit, making sure to call out any form of diagonal pressures that Deku's tries to, like I said previously, instill. Holding center stage at this point, calling out with the jab.
Deku's pressure has been on point for pretty much as long as I've been watching. Very curious how Pancakes will deal with that, because I haven't seen him play against Peach's first hand. I assume he has some experience from his Melee days, but... Oh, okay.
Ooh,
a little bit of percent.
And it's great recognition to call out the float, and make sure that you have relative positioning close towards the ledge, because it option selects Peach. If they try to go high, you can Rising Dare. If they try to go for ledge, you can Dare the approach before clip. So, making sure that you can call out any format of recovery. And once again, seeing it as it is.
Yep. Great patience. He clearly has some experience here that he's drawing from.
And once again, this is going to be a big patience war. One of the big abusive factors, especially for Peach, is waiting for forward smash on shields.
Oh, the dare coverage is...
Ooh, looking great!
I mean, Deku's crouch canceling, and like, it's doing something. It's not. He's not getting popped up directly, but... Oh, the down smash. The Great Equalizer bounces off, cancels the hit stun.
Yeah,
acrobatic-looking move there.
It definitely is the Great Equalizer, but for the matchup as a whole, he's had multiple stitches this game.
Has he really?
Yeah, that was his second one, it seemed.
I'm not sure. I feel like...
I don't think it... Maybe it wasn't a stitch.
Ooh. That was a very patient follow there. Deku's almost got away, but huge range of Mars Sword coming in clutch.
Oh.
Did not expect the edge cancel.
But I would have to say for this matchup, the actual Great Equalizer, instead of down smash, is turnips. It's a great possessive tool, especially when you're holding center stage, making sure that he can wall off any form of approach from Marth, and if he decides to grab it...
Ooh. Interesting. That's a cool option to turn winner from ledge and then like land on that platform and down smash. That's very creative.
So he went for the double jump, which immediately sends him down on platform. Next available frame, go for the down smash.
Deku has burned a lot of resources. On stage. Oh, Pancakes messes up. How much damage? Not much.
And with the jump, just making sure that he's covering the DI mix-up on the throw. Great feint.
Again, the pressure situations in the corner. Pancake shines there.
And this is exactly what we're going to see. So much patience from both. Because at any point, if Peach is at that Marth Rytus percent, Deku's is very familiar with how to punish. But when you're at 120, it becomes very questionable, especially offstage.
Okay, Deku being kind of slick right now. Gets undone under Marth. Catching him as he lands is a really important skill for the Peaches to have.
Oh!
Okay, keeps the combo going.
Yeah, and right now, especially when you're at this deficit, it's great to keep in mind that you can just download habits at this point. Any form of play, especially with platforms on Battlefield, maybe that's something you're going to take into mind on game two.
Oh, okay. Deku patient. The wave land back F smash not working out. But Pancakes has a decent amount of room to work with here.
Oh, yeah, and he tried to call out with the jab, making sure that he's not opting for any form of grounded moves. Oh, immediate avoidance of the grab, and in that arthritis percent.
Yikes.
That's some NorCal DI.
Sure, he'll be happy to hear about that.
Yeah, and it's expecting the roll. At that position, it's so familiar for Martz to keep that roll distance, because if you roll, it opts for an up tilt. If he goes for a jump, you opt with up tilt. If you opt towards the battlefield platform, up tilt. Exactly. And it's just baiting out with that down tilt, making sure that they want to move. The best option he could have gone for is probably wave dash back or roll towards the platform.
I could also see towards the ledge. If he like did a jump out of shield float to ledge, maybe he could have used the invincibility. Although he might have had too much damage for that, now that I think of it.
And at that point, you have to go towards ledge. In a risky situation...
Oh, that was a stitch. Okay, barely missed.
Oh, yeah, the stalling.
Deku very patient. I like that.
Yeah, and forcing these air-to-airs with the back air. Great to catch the roll away.
He just got some invincible tools from ledge. I'm not sure Pancake's ready for that. He's not ready for the rolling either. Fountain of Dreams is the...
Oh! He tried to get him with the pan! Yeah, but Marth, he was like, you want to cook? All right, we're cooking. Just try to catch it out.
Ooh. Grab priority.
And so good, fundamentally, to making sure that in the ground game, it's less of a crouch cancel war and more of a spot dodge war. We're seeing them opt for grabs. And it looks like Pancake's staying so consistent of the two.
Great timing there from Deku. So the pick, the counter pick is Fountain of Dreams, but I feel like some of these platforms when they're up are really helping out Pancake's. Now that they're down, he doesn't have as many landing options, so like you can see Deku taking advantage of that.
Mm-hmm. Now there is a big difference, especially with how FOD works on platforms. If he is trying to stay on any... Like, as he is placed, he can immediately go for, like, jump cancel aerials, and it's still going to apply the exact same pressure as if he was on the ground level. Mm-hmm. I feel like that is one of the qualities that is going to help out Peach, especially in this matchup.
Not to mention down smash on that platform.
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
Which he went for, but Pancakes was wise to, but not wise to losing his jump.
Ooh, great to catch out. And Shark with the dash attack, probably one of the most active frames... or active hitboxes that Peach has at that moment.
Right.
Catching the drift forward.
Very tight battle so far.
Mm-hmm. And still excellent play from both. It's really big on the micro as it is on the macro. That dip, very... Oh,
the turnip throw actually costing him his life.
And it was more because he dipped and caught with the fair catching Deku's jump there, making sure...
Oh, boy.
Oh.
I thought that was downer, but... Good 57% regardless.
Catching out with dash attack. And it looks like Deku in quite the pickle, it seems.
Mm-hmm. He really needs a strong reply right now. Okay, that could be it. Pancakes likes his down tilt, so getting over that. Oh, big back air. Is he going to be able to... Oh, that was creative. Yeah. Weak up air into F smash.
And I think the ground game plan is going to be the hardest part for Deku to apply. Mm-hmm. He's making sure that he's spacing very well off.
Ooh, I don't know about this. I've been the Ganon here. It's tricky.
I don't know. I still think Deku, in my eyes, and this could possibly be biased, is probably one of the best Ganondorfs out there.
I could see it.
In creativity of play, we've been seeing great burst movement in opportune times that, or minute times that we wouldn't usually see. And going to Battlefield, very questionable at this point.
You think?
This is very big on comfort, and especially with Pancakes' play coming out from Melee, I feel like this is definitely what we have to see. I would expect Pancakes to be good on Battlefield is what I'm trying to say.
All right, not the best DI there from Pancakes, but Ganondorf up in the air. Oh, look at this. This is crispy movement.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, cute wave land.
And it's making sure that this is probably going to solve the problem that he saw with Peach, where he's getting the hits, but it's not converting well. While with Ganon, he just needs the hit.
Oh, big downer. I think Pancake's crash canceled that somehow, because he didn't get sent very far at all. And the completion there with that nice float up air.
And it's exactly, there's no form of combo that needs to be had, especially with Ganondorf. You just need to get the hit, and then you need to make sure that you can abuse position off of this, especially with the advanced movement that we've seen from Deku previously. So.
Oh, tries to get the ledge cancel, not quite. But coming down with the forward air.
Yeah, and it's that form of creativity. I feel like with how the meta advancement with Ganondorf, a lot of people will go for the down B ledge cancel.
Ooh, Deku on the chase.
Oh, not, yep. I thought it was get up attack at that point. Going.
That would have been a nice choice. Oh, the spacing.
Yeah. Oh, no form of punish.
Yeah, you normally want to like dash out and grab.
Mm-hmm.
A little hard for Ganon to do that because his grab range is so short.
Yeah. Very, very stubby. Probably one of the worst aspects of the character as a whole.
Down throw, though.
Yes, down
like,
throw,
it
though.
Needs to be short. Deku doing pretty good here.
Working well off stage and great low recovery coming out from Pancakes, making sure that Ganondorf can't contest at that low percentage unless he wants to call the immediate upbeat. Oh, trying to go for Dacus there, actually.
I don't think that was a Dacus attempt. I think he just misread the DI. Because down throw into Dacus usually isn't a thing. So he just... Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So you can just run up smash. A number of arrows could have worked there. Up smash is a bit more committal, but gets the job done. Kills super early, though.
Playing off platform, and still a very risky situation. Yeah, tried to cover the form of DI, opting for an air rather than the second grab.
I don't think the re-grab works very well against Marth, and Nair, if you get both hits, does a lot of damage and sets up potential combo opportunities.
Yeah. The thing is that the SDI multiplier on the first hit of Nair from Ganon is so large that at that point, yeah,
wow.
That you can just immediately jump out of it, and that's exactly what we saw previously.
It looked to me more like a spacing thing, but oh, yeah, that still works.
Ooh.
Slick movement. Does he have a jump still? I'm not sure. He does. Oh, that's... Could have been very painful.
Mm-hmm. But still, with the hit, I think that's a dead Marth.
Such a quick turnaround. Mm-hmm. Deku was almost dead and then gets the hit himself.
Yeah, not opting for any form of shield drop. Just once again, center stage as much as possible. Messed up the ledge. Or the ledge cancel.
Yeah, the wavelength. So did Pancakes mess up the punish.
Ooh.
Interesting.
But Pancakes still trying to catch with that dip.
Oh.
Yeah. Telling him if he wants to get snotty, then he can definitely go for a punish off of it.
Last situation, Deku really fighting here. Gets caught. Pancake's always ready to cover that roll in.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, slick. Ooh. In the corner again. Tries to fight it with the dash attack, not quite working just yet.
Yeah, and he tried to grab him off of the landing, or the short hop fair into up air. Yeah, he's trying to hit him with all of these aerial mix-ups.
That's it. Pancakes with the 3-0 over Deku moving on to Grand Finals.
I think
we'll have to reevaluate.
Yeah. What I was going to say is that afterwards, there's definitely some thinking time that needs to go into just the overall game plan.
Right.
Because the movement was so concise, Pancakes was so good at abusing how slow Peach was in the beginning, even on a tighter stage like FOD. Mm-hmm. And it seemed like that was the general game plan. He was saying, oh, hey, if you want to dash dance me out, then I'll just put you on a smaller stage, something more uncomfortable for you, and still working out very well for him.